I never really concentrated on the topic of hope because hope was really never something I needed to think about. Even this mouth cover that we call it, you know, I have hope that it's gonna protect me from COVID or from other sicknesses. But really, I wanna speak today about hope because in the midst of so much that's going on inside the church and outside the church, many people are just beginning to experience the virtue of hope in a different way. First, they're experiencing the emotion of hopelessness. Like, what's gonna change? How's it gonna change? And when is it gonna change? One of the tactics of the devil, at least in my own heart, is when he just says, there's no hope or there's no time when there's gonna be a change. And so you just kind of give up. You kind of become lukewarm and you think, what's the point? What's the point of sacrificing? What's the point of praying? What's the point of even giving that extra oomph when you want to, but now you don't want to because you don't feel like it because there's no point to it. So you just feel kind of discouraged. Hope for me is doing those things when I don't want to do it, when it's hard to do it, when I'm somewhat discouraged. I don't always want to wear this little blue mouth cover, but I do it. I do it, I guess, because there's a certain sense of obedience to where I am in the work with the sisters and the children, wanting to be an example to them. But there's also hope that one day I'll never wear one of these again. And I really believe that as long as I can not concentrate on this, not see this always as an impediment, but see it as an opportunity to show God somewhat some obedience, I think, by trusting in Him, by doing what I'm asked to do. But then at the same time, hoping that knowing that God is in charge, that God is part of all of these moments that we're experiencing as a church and inside the church. Needless to say, as you know, I don't concentrate just on the scandal and I don't concentrate on all of the politics that the folks are facing. I have to step above that as a Catholic Christian man, as a Catholic Christian priest, and step above the noise and give people the reality that, you know, one day this is all gonna end. Christ is gonna win. But many people just are living in that sad routine monotony. Courage, folks. Whether you celebrate Thanksgiving in 3 weeks or 2 weeks or not, it doesn't matter. It's just a meal. But you can get people together. You can bring them together and give them joy and hope with a text, with an email, with a voice text, whatever it is. And then that way you can really grow in the virtue of hope. Be thankful. It's connected to the virtue of hope. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.